Top story, Turkey is pulling its troops out of a NATO exercise after President Erdogan says he was branded an enemy in the alliance's internal messaging network. A Norway's defence minister has already apologised for the gaffe, which further worsened relations between Ankara and NATO. With more, here's Paula Sleer.
Well, this is a perfect example of how small things can blow up and add to deteriorating relations in a powerful military alliance. It happened during a NATO training exercise in Norway, where a poster was unveiled of enemy countries. And the last thing you would expect is for the name of the Turkish President Erdogan to be on that poster, bearing in mind that Turkey is a key player in NATO. Now, the Turkish President Erdogan has responded by saying he's pulling out the 40 Turkish soldiers who were participating in this exercise.
They used an enemy chart in Norway. In that chart, there was my name and Ataturk's picture. I gave instructions to immediately withdraw our 40 soldiers. There can be no alliance like that.
Turkey is the second largest NATO military force and also a key American ally in the Middle East, so it's not clear how this incident is going to affect relations. The Secretary General of NATO has apologized, saying that the mistake was conducted by a civilian contractor and not an employee of NATO, and that it certainly doesn't represent their views. An investigation is underway. But it is perhaps ironic because the Secretary General is himself from Norway, where these military drills were taking place, so he's having to apologize for a mistake in his own country. The relationship between NATO and Turkey is already shaky. You have the Turkish President Erdogan criticizing concerns that were expressed by NATO over a military deal between Turkey and Russia involving S-400 anti-air defense missile systems. At the same time, NATO has repeatedly criticized Erdogan's apparent, what they say is an apparent autocratic tendencies. And there's also been a lot of scrutiny regarding Turkey's rule of law and democracy, particularly when it comes to NATO membership. So the last thing the relationship between Turkey and NATO needs is for something like this to happen, even if NATO is insisting that it was a mistake.